Estar con ustedes acá.
Many, many thanks for permitting me to be here with you tonight.
Agradezco primeramente a Dios por permitirnos, pues, por permitirme trasladarme desde un lugar tan lejano hasta estas tierras.
I express my gratitude in the first place maybe to God for allowing me to be able to move from a place so far away as where I live to be able to come to somewhere like here Street.
Y compartir pues un mensaje que tal vez para ustedes sea nuevo, pero para nosotros es de mucha trascendencia para un país como El Salvador.
And thanks to God for being able to be here to be able to transmit to you a message for us, which for you may be something that's new, but for us is something that now we've been a while in this struggle to be able to overcome, to transcend these problems we're having in El Salvador.
Bueno, El Salvador es un país muy, muy pequeño.
El Salvador is a very, very small country.
Estamos en el centro de América.
We're in the central part of America.
Somos un país con 6.5 millones de habitantes.
We've got 6.5 million inhabitants.
Y tenemos apenas 21.000 kilómetros cuadrados.
And we have barely 21,000 square kilometers for these 6.5 million inhabitants.
Hay un país vecino que es mucho, mucho más grande y que
está
queriendo quitarnos lo poquito que tenemos todavía de tierra en El Salvador.
Is in some struggle to over some of the joint or the border territory to work out where the border is taking some land away from us.
Pero bueno, la situación en El Salvador es preocupante, hablando en términos ambientales.
The situation in El Salvador, really, we can say in terms of the environmental issues, it's very worrying.
Nosotros, bueno, ya a partir de hace quizás unos 40 años cambiaron nuestra forma ancestral de cultivar nuestra tierra.
And so some 40 years ago, our ancestral form of cultivating the land was changed.
Antes, nuestros campesinos y campesinas no utilizaban elementos químicos para cultivar la tierra, se hacía pues.
Before, the men and women farm workers didn't use any chemicals to cultivate the land.
Se hacía puro esfuerzo natural de la misma tierra.
It was through just the working with the land itself, the bare land in which we grew our crops.
Y estos grandes proyectos que se meten a la fuerza en los países, pues son los que han permitido cambiar esas formas ancestrales de tratar de cultivar la tierra.
And really it's been these mega development projects which have come to our ancestral ways and have caused a change to the way in which we've cultivated our crops.
Puedo decir que en este año, bueno, en estos últimos años, ya pues haciendo análisis a nuestras aguas, a nuestros ríos, el 92% de nuestras aguas están altamente contaminadas.
So looking at where we are today as a consequence of these projects, we're able to say that probably 92% of the rivers, the waterways we have in El Salvador, are contaminated now and have problems in maintaining life.
Este año también ya contabilizamos 70 personas muertas a causa de enfermedad en los riñones por consumo de aguas envenenadas, por
so
prácticamente intoxicadas.
In the past year we've carried out a study to look at the health of people, and one of the things we've discovered is that there's been in the communities where we carried out the study, there were probably about 70 people who died because of some illnesses of their kidneys, in which the water which they were drinking from the waterways or from the wells had some levels of poison in it, and that is what caused them to die, you know, earlier than they would have otherwise.
Cada día se agudiza más el padecimiento en nuestra gente de enfermedades en los riñones.
And so every day it seems that there's a higher level of the occurrence of illnesses of the kidneys.
Esta situación de problemas ambientales también le dan la categoría según la ONU a El Salvador de ser el segundo país de América Latina más deforestado después de Haití.
These environmental problems, we could say, has given us the categorization from the United Nations organization of being throughout all of the Americas the second most deforested country in the Americas.
También nuestro país está ya presentando situaciones difíciles en cuanto a lo que es el tema del cambio climático.
Also, our country is facing many problems in issues relating to what we know as climate change.
Y entonces la ONU, las Naciones Unidas lo han catalogado como ser el cuarto país con alto riesgo de vulnerabilidad ante la presencia del cambio climático.
And so the United Nations, again in its categorization of the levels of risk faced by different countries for climate change, it's put us as number four as far as the risk that can come from, or for vulnerability from the effects of climate change.
Prácticamente nosotros en El Salvador constantemente experimentamos situaciones como, bueno, somos un país también volcánico, tenemos en ese territorio pequeños 5 volcanes activos.
And so one of the other issues which we confront as part of our topography is that we're a volcanic country, and so in the territory of El Salvador there are 5 volcanoes which are still active now.
A cada rato estamos sintiendo sismos.
And every so often we feel some shaking of the earth, some earthquakes.
Y bueno, las políticas de Estado no han sido lo suficientemente fuertes para poder detener construcciones en lugares inadecuados.
And so the policies which the state has established have not been sufficient to be able to meet the needs of the people in the country.
Y por eso se experimentan casos como el soterramiento o cómo se o las lavas que provocan a veces los temblores que dejan ciudades completas bajo tierra.
And so that is what has provoked what we would call the landslides, which have really buried entire villages when, because of the mudslides that come when there's heavy storms and the deforestation, the land is loosened and then falls down the hillside and covers over all the houses which are there down below.
Un volcán el año 2011.
In 2011, one of the volcanoes.
Llovió por un lapso de 3 horas y acumuló tanta agua que
we had very heavy rain for about 3 hours, and so much water was gathered into the cone of the volcano.
Que, bueno, al final terminó explotando quizás por mitad del volcán y todo lo que llevó consigo al paso, pues, dejó soterradas
so
comunidades completas.
As the water from this incredible amount of rain fell, the water in the volcano started increasing, and it reached a stage where the mouth of the volcano was no longer able to detain it, and so part of that caved in and caused a great mudslide, and so there were many houses that were just completely covered over by this massive mudslide.
Esta situación de vulnerabilidad que ya presentamos se complica más cuando conocemos que hay interés de empresas extranjeras por explotar nuestros recursos minerales.
This situation becomes even more complex when we discover that there are, adding to this difficulties we have, foreign companies that are coming to El Salvador and looking at ways of carrying out some exploitation of our natural resources for their own purposes.
El Bueno, la fiebre del oro en América Latina y en el mundo cada día aumenta más.
Gold fever, we can say, in Latin America and in the whole world, really, is growing more and more every day.
Y este es un tema que preocupa mucho a las comunidades, a países como, como el nuestro.
And this is a theme or an issue which is something that really worries the communities like ours in a country like ours.
Y por eso El Salvador pues viene luchando desde el 2004 para que no haya minería en este país.
And it's because of this that since 2004, El Salvador, the people of El Salvador, have been conducting a struggle to achieve a situation where there would not be any mining conducted in our country.
Y hemos logrado hasta la fecha parar estos proyectos.
And in fact, we've been successful that from 2004 to now, we've been successful in stopping any mines proceeding.
Porque para nosotros es más importante y más significativo tener nuestros alimentos básicos para el consumo diario que tener oro o que tener pues que regalar estos recursos minerales a las transnacionales.
So for us it's more important really to be able to have the basic necessities that we need for food and health and well-being in our communities on a day-to-day basis rather than having this supposed advantage to us of having gold to be able to add some wealth perhaps to the foreign companies.
En El Salvador se piensa o se pretende llevar a cabo más de 70 proyectos mineros.
In El Salvador, what is being contemplated is for the opening up of perhaps 60 or 70 different mines.
Y resulta que estos proyectos están ubicados en todo lo que es la franja norte de nuestro país.
And it turns out that all of the possible locations for where these mines, where they want to develop these mines, are in the northern band of the country, the mountainous band across the northern border.
Esta zona es, esta franja norte es el lugar donde hace la recarga acuífera el único río más importante que tenemos en el país.
But the other thing we have to take into account of the fact that these mine locations are on this northern band is that this northern band also has the characteristic of being the water catchment area for the only significant river that we have in our country.
Y nuestro temor es que si se desarrollan estos proyectos,
and so our fear is that if these projects are carried out,
este río va a terminar contaminado con ese mineral, mejor dicho, con esa sustancia química que utilizan, indispensable para la minería, como es el cianuro.
Our fear is that this one river that we really rely on will end up being contaminated with this chemical, which is the chemical which they use for any gold mines. It's the chemical known as cyanide.
Y es allí donde, pues, hemos hecho la lucha, hemos hecho la resistencia desde las comunidades.
And so that's the point in which we, learning about this, have really begun our struggle, and we've begun to offer resistance to these efforts to start these projects.
Pero también se han unido a nuestro esfuerzo, a nuestra lucha, sectores muy importantísimos en la sociedad salvadoreña como...
But as well, we've not just been alone as rural villages, rural communities in offering resistance, but in fact there have been important sectors from diverse places within our society, organizations like...
Como la Conferencia Episcopal del Salvador.
Like the Episcopal Conference, the Bishops' Conference of El Salvador.
Universidades muy prestigiosas en nuestro país.
Very
la
prestigious
UCA, por ejemplo.
Universities in our country, the UCA, the Catholic University of Central America, the Jesuit University.
La Procuraduría para la Defensa de los Derechos Humanos, o sea, son amplios sectores muy reconocidos.
The Ombudsman for the Environment, sorry, the Ombudsman for Human Rights. People like this who are very well recognized figures or organizations within our country.
Que pues alzan la voz y dicen que en El Salvador no debe de haber minería, y lo hemos sustentado en estudios técnicos científicos.
And they've raised their voice, and their message has been that in our country, El Salvador, really there should not be mines of this nature. And we've carried out, in fact, studies as well to validate these technical or scientific studies.
Entonces hemos podido hasta el día de hoy parar estos proyectos.
And so up until today we've been able to stop these projects.
Pero esto ha ocasionado para el Estado, bueno, primeramente violación a los derechos humanos.
But this has provoked for the state violation of human rights.
De parte de las empresas.
By the companies.
Asesinatos.
There have been murders.
Amenazas a líderes comunitarios.
Threats which have been made against community leaders.
En el 2009.
In 2009.
Asesinaron a tres compañeros. They
murdered three of our of my companions who were working in environmental issues.
Incluyendo a una mujer embarazada de 8 meses, pues la asesinaron a ella y le mataron, pues le asesinaron también a su bebé que llevaba de 8 meses en su vientre.
And amongst these three who were killed was also a woman who was 8 months pregnant. And so really we can say that they were not only killing her, but also killing the baby she carried.
Este país que ha sido víctima de la voracidad de estas empresas.
So this, our country, which has been a victim of the voraciousness of these companies.
También, pues, ha sido demandado por 315 millones de dólares de parte de la empresa hacia el Estado salvadoreño.
Has now we've seen that there's a new thing that's happened, and that's been the opening up of a lawsuit against the government of El Salvador, against the nation, by the mining companies, demanding compensation of $315 million.
Hay un tribunal que ha sido creado para velar por los intereses de las grandes corporaciones.
There's a tribunal or a panel which has been established on an international level, and its role really is to look out for the interests of the great, the large multinational corporations.
Y en este tribunal pues se ventila o se lleva esta demanda millonaria para El Salvador.
And so it's within this tribunal in which the lawsuit is being heard against the government of El Salvador.
Que es un tribunal que únicamente le interesa el dinero o los recursos económicos, no le interesan los temas ambientales que tengan que vivir los países.
And really the way in which this international tribunal is structured is purely to look at economic factors. It has no interest in the environmental issues that might impact on a country, or social issues, nothing else, just economic.
Esa es la realidad que vivimos en El Salvador.
That's the reality which we're living in El Salvador.
Hoy en octubre, recientemente, la Pacific Rim vende su proyecto a esta empresa australiana.
And so recently we had something new that happened just in the month of October. Pacific Rim, the Canadian company, Canadian mining company, which had been working to develop the mine near my village, was sold as a company to an Australian mining company, Oceana Gold.
Y la vende por 10.2 millones de dólares.
And so it was effectively sold for $10.2 million.
Y la demanda que se enfrenta al Estado salvadoreño es por 315 millones.
But if it was worth only $10.2 million, that's strange because the amount in which they're demanding in their compensation case against the Salvadoran government is $315 million.
Entonces no entendemos. ¿Cuál es el negocio de la Oceana Gold con la Pacific Rim?
We really don't understand what is this business deal that Oceana Gold is pulling off with Pacific Rim.
Porque el Estado salvadoreño pues ha defendido fuertemente esta demanda en el CIADI.
Because the Salvadoran government has stood up to fight against this lawsuit which is being heard in the ICSID.
Y hasta hoy pues podemos decir que el Estado salvadoreño ha salido victorioso en la defensa de del mismo estado.
And really we could say that so far now, in the years in which the legal proceedings have been going on, the Salvadoran government has been up to date successful in holding off against the lawsuit.
Entonces no entendemos cuál es la verdadera el verdadero interés de la Oceana Gold cuando pues en El Salvador hay una gran resistencia.
So we don't understand what's the real, what's really behind things, what's the real interests of Oceana Gold in buying this company, given there's such a strong resistance in El Salvador.
Y pues ellos quieren llevar a cabo estos proyectos en nuestro país.
And so what is the interest they have in carrying out these projects in our country?
Para nosotros es de suma importancia el que el pueblo australiano, el pueblo consciente, por supuesto, australiano, sepa pues que sus empresas, o que mejor dicho, empresas australianas.
For us it's of total importance that the people of Australia should know that this is going on, that this is what's happening with the investments of the Australian people through an Australian mining company.
Impone sus intereses ante la voluntad de un pueblo pues que ha decidido no ceder el país a los proyectos mineros.
And so that this company is wanting to impose its will over the clear will of a nation which has stated that it doesn't want to cede its territory to any of these mining projects.
Porque nosotros hemos enfrentado la Pacific Rim.
Because we've stood up now to Pacific Rim.
Y aunque sabemos que la Oceana Gold es una empresa mucho más fuerte económicamente hablando.
And whilst we know that Oceana Gold is a company which is much more economically strong.
Nosotros no vamos a dejar de luchar, no vamos a dejar de insistir en que en El Salvador no debe de haber minería.
So despite that, we won't be, despite the size, we're not going to be intimidated, and we're not going to stop insisting that El Salvador should be a country without these mines.
Entonces nosotros llamamos, hacemos el llamado también a esta empresa a que escuche el clamor del pueblo salvadoreño.
So we've issued a call to this company, asking that they should hear and respect the call of the voice of the Salvadoran people.
Porque pues seguirá encontrando resistencia y claro, si la empresa dice que va a negociar con el gobierno salvadoreño.
Because if the company says it's going to negotiate with the Salvadoran government.
Pero no dice si va a negociar con las comunidades que son las legítimas dueñas de sus territorios, de sus terrenos en las localidades.
But it doesn't say if it's going to negotiate with the communities who are the legitimate stakeholders and owners of lands around the areas where they want to develop their projects.
Y entonces es allí donde pues va a encontrar la resistencia de este pueblo que ya tomó esa decisión de no hacer pues proyectos mineros en este país.
And so that is where they're going to find the greatest level of resistance in many ways, when they try to confront this people who've already made a clear decision not to accept mining projects in our country. Wondering if there's questions.
I'm wondering, with these murders that have taken place, have they found who was responsible? Was it the mining companies?
Han encontrado los responsables, era la empresa minera propiamente.
Nosotros hemos tirado pues a la fiscalía esa responsabilidad porque son ellos los responsables de hacer esas investigaciones.
We've really put the onus onto the Director of Public Prosecutions, who has the responsibility for finding out who was responsible for these murders.
Sin duda hay fuertes sospechas.
And without any doubt, there are very strong suspicions about who's responsible.
Que hay involucramiento de las empresas mineras, de la empresa minera Pacific Green.
Suspicions that there is some involvement by the Pacific Rim mining company.
Porque las comunidades antes que llegara la empresa.
Because the communities
vivían,
before the mining company arrived, these communities lived in a way that was calm. They lived well.
A partir de la presencia de las empresas mineras y de empezar a comprar voluntades.
So from the time of the arrival of the mining company and from its process of commencing to buy consciences.
Pues es donde se abre el camino para sospechar de que hay involucramiento de la empresa Pacific Green.
It's on this basis that it's these conflict in the community only commenced from that moment is why we have grounds for suspecting that there is some involvement in Pacific Rim in this process.
Pero claro, esto le compete a nuestras autoridades, como la fiscalía, profundizar en estos asesinatos.
They're not our responsibility to be assigning blame or responsibility, but rather it's the authorities within our country who are the ones who should be taking a stronger role in working out what's going on behind these murders.
So this is now 4 years ago.
2009.
El 2009 mataron, bueno, asesinaron a.
In 2009.
A Marcelo Rivera.
They killed Marcelo Rivera.
Ramiro Rivera.
Ramiro Rivera.
A Dora Sorto.
Dora Sorto.
Y su bebé de 8 meses.
And her 8-month-old.
En el 2011. Asesinaron a otro también activista, a otra persona muy cercana a la lucha.
Someone who was an activist, someone who was very involved in the struggle.
En el mismo 2011 también asesinan a un hijo de una activista.
In 2011 as well, the other thing that happened was that they killed the son of one of the activists involved in the movement.
Y no existe ningún argumento por el cual puedan decir que lo asesinaron porque era un vandálico, porque en realidad el último asesinato era un joven de 21 años.
And so there's no suspicion, no reason, no evidence which really points to thinking that his violent death might have been in any way linked to crimes or gangs or the other sorts of things which go on here, because he as a young man, he was 21 years old.
Un joven que estaba estudiando segundo año de carrera de ingeniería industrial, becado.
A young man who had achieved a scholarship and was studying his second year of mechanical engineering. A scholarship for that university.
Y entonces no hay ningún indicio que diga que el joven era un joven cualquiera o un joven metido en problemas.
There's been no indications whatsoever that this young man might have been in any way involved in social problems, which in many cases are linked to the violence which happens in our country.
Él, su trabajo era estudiar y luego también acompañaba a delegaciones cuando visitaban el lugar.
And he
a
also used
mostrar
to,
cómo se le había secado la fuente de agua a su mamá.
He used to accompany the delegations that would arrive to visit our areas, and he'd be a guide for them and showing them some of the springs which had dried up as a consequence of.
Porque esa familia primero pues se le secaron las fuentes de agua.
Because for this family on their land, the land was made more valuable for having natural springs on it. And then when these springs dried up,
ella tenía una finca, se le secó totalmente también.
They had a farm, and on that farm, the water supply dried up completely as well.
Tenía una granja de cerdos, terminó vendiéndolos o terminó con su negocio porque no tenía agua para cuidarlos. Entonces,
they had a pig raising business, and they had to wind it up. They weren't able to continue with it because they just didn't have the source of water which they needed in order to be be able to conduct this business.
Entonces la mamá de este joven lo que hacía era denunciar y decir, por culpa de la Pacific Rim, yo no tengo agua, yo no tengo mi finca y yo no tengo mi negocio.
And so the mother of this young man, she used to say, it's the fault of Pacific Rim because of the what they've been doing to the water sources during their exploration. It's their fault that I don't have water. It's their fault that I've had to close my business. It's their fault that there's no water on the farm.
Ella lo denunciaba públicamente. Era una denuncia constante a través de los medios de comunicación.
She publicly made this denouncement of Pacific Rim for this in public occasions and through the media.
Y entonces nuestra sospecha es de dónde provino la muerte a este joven.
And so our suspicion is, well, given that was the circumstance, what was it behind this? What provoked the death of this young man?
Pues esos son los actos pues que nosotros decimos que se investiguen a estas empresas, so, más que todo la Pacific Rim.
What, so our position has been that given these circumstantial indicators, what we've really asked is that there should be a profound investigation to find out what role, if any, these companies have, but in particularly Pacific Rim.
What do we know of Oceania and Gold in Australia? I've never heard of them.
¿Qué sabemos de la Oceana Gold aquí en Australia? Yo nunca he oído de ellos.
Nosotros lo poco que sabemos es que
the little we know about them.
Tiene un gran proyecto en las Filipinas.
That they have a very large gold project in the Philippines.
Que allá también la Comisión de Derechos Humanos la
well,
ha denunciado que esta empresa es violadora de los derechos humanos en la Filipina.
The National Commission of Human Rights in the Philippines has denounced this company, has named this company as being an abuser, a violator of human rights.
Que una parte importante de las acciones de los pensionados también van para capital, para el capital de esta empresa.
And remembering that an important part of where the capital which these sorts of companies and this particular company is operating with is the pension funds of superannuants here in Australia, and it's these funds which are what is financing these projects.
Y por lo que acaba de mencionar Oceana Gold, ellos dicen que están acostumbrados a ejecutar proyectos o hacer proyectos en zonas ecológicamente hablando frágiles.
And so one of the things that since Oceana Gold purchased Pacific Rim, in a communique which they put out, they've said that they have a lot of experience in dealing with mining projects in areas which are very ecologically sensitive.
Y que pueden negociar con gobiernos de derecha, de izquierda, de centro, de donde sea, ellos pues están acostumbrados a negociar este tipo de proyectos.
Claim to have experience in negotiating with governments of all sorts, left-wing or right-wing governments, it doesn't matter, but they've demonstrated their capacity to be able to negotiate with these governments.
So has any approach been made to the Australian government? Are they aware of this?
Si ha hecho alguna solicitud al gobierno australiano, ellos se dan cuenta de lo que está pasando, de eso.
¿Que la Oceana Gold?
Si el gobierno de Australia se da cuenta de eso.
No lo sé.
I don't know.
We
have some meetings in Canberra next week. So it's que vamos a Canberra la capital de la semana pasada. La semana que viene.
A question.
Sorry, I think this one.
Just a question.
Is gold the only resource, or are there other resources in the area that maybe someone wants to develop?
O hay otros recursos también que realmente quieren sacar.
Somos riquísimos en minerales, tenemos mucho oro,
very rich in minerals,
mucha plata y también tenemos uranio.
And we also have some uranium.
Sí, es por ser volcánico nuestro
because
país.
It's volcanic country.
Hay una concentración muy fuerte de oro.
There's a strong concentration of gold.
La empresa Pacific Rim decía que iba a sacar por tonelada de
Pacific Rim said that they would be getting ton loads
Entre 10 y 11 onzas de oro por tonelada de roca molida. Bueno, esos son cálculos que ellos manejan más técnico.
That for every ton of rock which they would get out, they'd be able to get 12 to 14 ounces of gold from each ton.
Pero que en realidad pues hay una muy buena concentración de oro en nuestros suelos.
So it's true, there's a very high concentration of gold in our lands.
Can I just, since the assassination of Oscar Romero,
desde el asesinato de Oscar Romero,
El Salvador has dropped a little bit off the radar as far as our church goes.
El Salvador como que se ha caído un poco en cuanto a nuestra iglesia.
What is the church's position on the matter? The church in El Salvador's position.
¿Cuál es la posición que ha tomado la iglesia en El Salvador en cuanto a eso?
En cuanto a este tema ha sido muy clara, muy.
So as far as this theme goes, the position has been very clear.
Debo decir que hay mucho que desear de nuestra iglesia en El Salvador.
Easily say that there's a lot to be left to desire about church in El Salvador.
Pero en el tema ambiental sí está muy bien posicionada y ha dicho.
But in the environmental theme, it's really taken a very good position.
Y ha dicho constantemente que no debe de haber minería en El Salvador.
And it's taken a constant and clear position of saying that there should not be mining in El Salvador.
Ha sido bien clara la posición. Creo en otros temas seguramente no,
totally
pero
clear.
En este tema
in other themes, it's been,
hay mucha claridad.
They haven't had that clarity, but on this theme, yes, the church and bishops have been very clear.
And can we hear just a little bit about the government? Is the government a benign dictatorship or is it left-wing democracy?
Y a ver si nos puede contar un poco del gobierno, qué es un dictadura benigno o es un gobierno de izquierda, es democrático o cómo es el gobierno de El Salvador?
Pues el gobierno de El Salvador entró a través de la izquierda salvadoreña.
The current government, the presidency we have, entered into power through the left wing.
Pero bueno, ya puesto en el gobierno, se ha identificado
power,
muy poco con la izquierda salvadoreña.
They really haven't linked themselves very closely with the left, Salvador left.
Han habido cosas buenas.
There have been some very good things they've done.
Pero han habido cosas no tan buenas.
But there have also been things which have not been so good.
Creo que el tiempo es muy muy corto también para evaluarlo si todo lo que está haciendo está haciéndolo bien.
I think the time is very short to be able to evaluate
whether
or not everything they're doing has been done well.
Y si bien es cierto, El Salvador tiene el gobierno, la izquierda tiene el gobierno.
And so whereas it may be true that El Salvador has a government of the left,
Pero no tiene el poder legislativo, lo tiene la derecha.
But the fact they have the presidency doesn't mean they also have legislative power, because the majority in the legislative assembly are the right-wing party Arena.
Entonces prácticamente, pues, quizás así en términos generales, el gobierno termina su periodo, pero hay muchas cosas que desear de él.
The current government is about to finish its term, but there's many things we'd still wish to see developed by them.
Y una de las cosas peores que ha hecho en su gobierno es firmar un TLC con la Unión Europea.
One of the worst things which this current presidency that they've done is to sign a free trade agreement with the European Union.
Y ratificó también el TLC nuevamente con Estados Unidos, ahora se llama Asocio para el Crecimiento, pero en realidad es otro TLC, una ratificación más del TLC con Estados Unidos.
And so the other thing they've done is to ratify and extend the free trade agreement with the United States. So now it's called the Partnership for Development, and but really it's just a continuation of the previous free trade agreements.
Por eso digo que deja mucho que desear. Nosotros esperábamos.
And it's because of this that I'd say there's really a lot that we'd more than we would have wished to
más trascendentales y pues termina su periodo.
There's other transcendental issues which we
y todavía hace falta mucho que desear de él.
They're about to finish their term and there's still lots more to be seen.
Is there a drug lord problem as well?
Tiene problemas de los grandes mafiosos de las drogas, del narcotráfico.
El Salvador no es tan fuerte como Guatemala.
In El Salvador, sí. It's not as strong as it is in Guatemala.
El tema de la mafia es un poquito más controlado que en Guatemala.
Sin embargo, cartels or mafias or drug lords, it's not as strong in El Salvador as it is, for example, the next door in Guatemala.
Hay algunas zonas en el país, como la zona oriental, donde hay mucho narcotráfico.
There's a few regions of our country where there are higher problems with the drug cartels, but it's not nearly as much.
Pero este tema de narcotráfico está más aliado con la derecha salvadoreña.
But this theme of drug trafficking towards the north is something that's been more linked to the right-wing parties in El Salvador.
Nosotros conocemos de funcionarios públicos de Arena que se han enriquecido de la noche a la mañana. Se han enriquecido.
They've become very wealthy from one day to the next.
De un día para otro amanecen millonarios.
So one day they're kind of middle class, the next day they're millionaires. So something's going on.
Entonces, la única sospecha es que es narcotráfico, de otra forma no pueden enriquecerse.
It must be drug trafficking. There'd be no other form to be able to have that economic change so quickly.
In relation to the lawsuit or the court case that's happening with Pacific Grim, where is that at this current state? Is it being resolved? Does it look good, bad?
So the buenas perspectivas, malas perspectivas, en qué nivel está ahorita la demanda.
El proceso está inicial y hoy por hoy la defensa del Estado salvadoreño anda pues trabajando fuertemente en recopilar o recoger testimonios.
The legal case is still within the ICSID and it's at a stage in which the defense attorneys employed by the Salvadoran government are collecting testimonies from people.
En evaluar la supuesta inversión de la empresa Pacific Rim en las comunidades.
As part of a process of evaluating the supposed investment that Pacific Rim claimed to have made into the communities.
Porque ellos argumentan haber invertido en construcción de escuelas, en construcción de carreteras, en tantas cosas que no es cierto.
Put social infrastructure investments in, that they've constructed schools, that they've constructed roads, and so many other claims which we as the local people know it's just not true at all.
Entonces el próximo año, no recuerden qué mes, si es en mayo o en septiembre,
so
va a ser...
So next year, I can't remember which month, whether it's May or in September.
Se van a presentar todos esos, esas pruebas o esos alegatos,
so
como le
all
dicen.
All of this evidence is going to be presented at that time.
Pues iba a ser el juicio o el veredicto final prácticamente del caso.
So, as a consequence of that, we'd receive the final verdict of the case.
Nosotros consideramos que, pues, la defensa va a hacer un muy buen papel, pero también.
It seems to us that the defense is conducting a very good role, the way in which they're carrying out the case.
Tenemos el apoyo de organizaciones sociales en Canadá y Estados Unidos que están.
We have the support of social organizations in Canada and the United States.
Que están trabajando fuertemente por desvirtuar o por desmentir, por denegar todo lo que la empresa.
Who are working very hard to be able to pues, reveal as lies all of these claims which the company has made about their investment.
Pues nosotros esperamos un resultado favorable para el Estado salvadoreño,
we
para el pueblo salvadoreño.
We hope to receive a positive result for the Salvadoran people.
Have you had any publicity in the newspapers, and what should we do to support in this? Write letters to the government?
Sí.
En entrevistas, no, bueno, como vine hace dos días,
I only arrived,
solamente
as far as interviews go, because I arrived here only just 2 days ago.
Solamente hemos hecho una entrevista en una radio.
We just had one interview so far in a radio
Me
station.
Parece que es pregrabada, no sé cuándo va a salir.
Pre-recorded. I'm not sure when it's coming out.
Claro, por supuesto, espero en el transcurso de estos días poder hacer más entrevistas.
I hope that in the next couple of days there may be opportunities to carry out more interviews.
Y en lo que queda de, bueno, lo que esperaría yo o lo que esperaríamos nosotros de ustedes es primero
what
la solidaridad que es importante.
What I'm hoping to come from you would the first place would be your solidarity, which is so important.
Yo creo que si nosotros hubiéramos estado solos como salvadoreños, los proyectos mineros ya hubieran ya se hubieran realizado.
I think that if we'd been alone through this process, then we wouldn't have survived, and that these mining projects would already be in production phase.
Y luego, pues, hay que recordarle a la Oceana Gold que es una empresa.
And as well, I guess that we need to remind Oceana Gold
que pues respete los derechos humanos, o mejor dicho, que respete la decisión soberana de un pueblo que ya decidió.
That it should respect the human rights, or no, actually better, that it should respect the sovereign decision of a people who have made their decision.
Yo pienso que puede estar a su alcance de elaborar una carta, enviarla a la Oceana Gold.
I wonder if it might be in your capacity to be able to write a letter to Oceana Gold.
Y pues que se haga sentir que el clamor del pueblo salvadoreño es
and
que
so
no es que no va a ceder.
The call, the cry of the Salvadoran
así de fácil.
People, the Salvadoran people are not going to cede, not going to back down from the sovereign decision they made.
Pues no estamos pues dispuestos a que se den estos proyectos en nuestro país.
We're not prepared to accept that these projects should be carried out in our country.
De dólares americanos.
US dollars.
Si nosotros somos un país dolarizado, de
casi a country which shamefully has been dollarized. We've lost our own currency.
Can we ask how much the miners actually get paid?
¿Cuánto es que pagarían a los mineros, la gente de la mina, los trabajadores? But there is no mine yet, so.
La Pacific Rim en su estudio que hizo,
Pacific Rim in the study which he carried out,
dijo que iba a generar 600 empleos.
They said that they were going to generate 600 jobs.
En 8 años de duración del proyecto.
In the 8 years of duration of the project.
Y que se le iba a pagar a cada trabajador $6 el día.
They were going to pay them $6 a day.
No sé si eso se multiplica por un mes, no sé cuánto
sure
día, pero $6 diario era lo que prometía.
$6 a day, that's what they were promising.
Pagarle al trabajador. Pero 608 empleos en comparación de una población de más de 100,000 habitantes y cabañas.
600 jobs compared to a population which is maybe 100,000 people in our province.
Insignificante.
It's pretty insignificant when you think about it. It's really, it's nothing.
Y son empleos temporales.
And they're only temporary employment, temporary jobs as well.
Y los daños, pues, es
damage.
And now we know Oceana Gold's owned by Gina Rinehart. $6 a day.
She's
$2. The dueño de Oceana Gold es la gran billonaria australiana, Gina Rinehart. Pero no, por pagar un poco, tal vez. Tracking down, I guess we'll be publishing some more information about who the major shareholders of Oceana Gold are. And yes, today we had meetings with some analysts from the finance sector who are working on preparing reports. And I guess these people maybe who are more on our side, but preparing reports on the risks associated, financial risks associated with some of these projects. So they were collecting information. They work for some of the bigger name financial organizations, which we superannuation with.
Sean, do you know yet where they are apart from the Philippines?
¿A dónde está Oceana Gold, además de las Filipinas?
No, no sé. Nueva Zelanda. Sí, Nueva Zelanda. Sí, solo sé que está en Nueva Zelanda y la Filipina. Sí, no sé dónde más.
So we only know that they're in New Zealand and the Philippines. I'm not sure where else.
I was wondering about that.
Habla mucho la Oceana Gold de la responsabilidad social, ¿no?
About
sabemos a qué se refiere cuando
social responsibility,
cuando habla de responsabilidad social,
what's their definition of this social responsibility?
Que son muy responsables, dicen,
very responsible,
al implementar sus proyectos.
In implementing their projects, which communities don't want. There's actually quite a lot on YouTube as well, which is pretty textbook Green Berets counterinsurgency theory of their work in the Philippines. It's the battle for the hearts and minds, so whether or not they've had actual ex-Green Berets from El Salvador, Afghanistan, or wherever that have been employed by them to be conducting these hearts and minds psychological psyops, psychological operations from the Pentagon speak. So yes, we get to hear about the collateral damage of Ramiro and Marcelo and Dora's baby.
Sería interesante que si ustedes tienen acercamiento también a los obispos, si se puede hacer un pronunciamiento en conjunto y hacerlo llegar a nuestros obispos en El Salvador.
Important if you have any connections with the bishops here, that if there was some way of being able to, for the bishops here to make some statement, and which could then offer support to the bishops of El Salvador and the position they're taking.
Claro, ese es un tema que hay que hablarlo también con ellos, ¿verdad?
This is a topic which maybe needs to be talked about.
Como también alzan esa voz. Pues apoyando
a
El Salvador.
The Salvador Bishops Conference. Vitalina was about to mention.
Bueno, lo cierto es que este tema es, pues, complicadísimo, y bueno,
this issue really has got a lot of twists and turns in it. You could say it's quite a bit complicated. One of the anecdotes we have about
contamos en este tema es que
anecdote we tell in this theme.
Nosotros hicimos a Monseñor Sáenz la calle, bueno, aparte de las movilizaciones que hacíamos para
through the early days of this, when we had a number of social mobilizations, we had protests on the streets of the capital, San Salvador, and that we had some contact with the then Archbishop, Spaniard, his surname is Sanz Lacalle.
Monseñor Sanz Lacalle es químico de profesión.
Now, Archbishop Sanz Lacalle, who's now retired, his original profession was as it was in chemistry.
Y él, pues, fue uno de los que se pronunciaron. Y él decía, desde mi profesión como químico, sé que
he was one of the early ones who actually made statements, made pronouncements. And he said, from my original academic professional background in chemistry, I'm able to say
sé que la minería utiliza cianuro.
It's very clear to me that this mining uses cyanide.
Y si a mí me garantiza, decía él, la Pacific Rim que va a hacer minería sin cianuro, pues.
And if Pacific Rim can guarantee to me that they're going to conduct mining without cyanide,
pues que se haga minería acá en El Salvador. De lo contrario, pues,
in favor of mining
es mejor que se retire, que se vaya
de
El Salvador.
Guarantee that to me, then it's better they get out of the country.
Porque en realidad en ninguna parte del mundo hay minería sin utilizar cianuro.
There's nowhere in the world in which there's been mining of this sort, which is not using cyanide to extract the coal from the ore.
Y bueno, el cianuro es un elemento
tan mortal que
una pequeña cantidad es capaz de matar a una persona. Parece que ese fue un elemento que se utilizó en la Segunda Guerra Mundial, me parece, en la guerra de los nazis.
In the Second World War, Segunda Guerra Mundial, sí, at the War of the Nazis, this is what they used.
Fue el elemento más utilizado. Y entonces los proyectos mineros se vuelve como una guerra más.
So it seems like
la utilización de cianuro
the mining projects become one more war.